The eighth hole at par five, by the way, is the one on which lies, or stands, I should say, the famous Hinkle Tree, which was brought into play by, well, Al Troutwig. Took a look at it, found out all about it. Let him tell us about it.
Let me tell you a little bit about the eighth hole at Inverness. It's relatively famous. A par five, 528-yard dogleg left. Now, off the tee, there aren't many options here. You obviously want to stay straight, avoid the bunkers on the left, and certainly try to avoid these huge trees that line the fairway. They come into play. Oh, and there's one more tree that comes into play. This one right here. Yep, that's right. It certainly does come into play when you talk about the eighth hole. It wasn't there when the first round began, when the U.S. Open was held here in 1979, but it was there when the second round began. Let me tell you why. As all the players teed off to begin the U.S. Open here that year, Lon Hinkle was paired with Chichi Rodriguez and Greg Norman. When they arrived at the eighth hole, maybe everybody in the gallery thought Lon Hinkle's address was a little crooked. But what Lon Hinkle was doing was applying his knowledge of geometry. He knew the shortest distance between two points was a straight line. And that's why he didn't tee off that way. He teed off that way, creating the Hinkle shortcut, if you will. He played his ball up the 17th fairway, eventually reached the green in two, and birdied the hole. Chichi Rodriguez tried to follow, was not as successful, and Greg Norman decided to play it straight. Well, that really shocked the USGA Executive Committee. They had a meeting into the night and tried to decide what to do to preserve the integrity of the eighth hole at Inverness. Should they move the tee forward? Nope, that would change the hole. They decided to bring out the bulldozers and the shovels and plant that tree. A pretty drastic action, because when the players arrived the next morning, there it stood, 7 feet shorter than it is now. And what effect did it have? Not much. Lon Hinkle teed it off right through the branches, headed up the 17th fairway, and birdied the hole again. But since then, this tree has stood as a reminder of what Lon Hinkle tried to do that day. He tried to birdie the par 5 eighth hole by taking the shortcut. Today, if you tried to do it, it's pretty impossible. You see, the Hinkle Tree still stands guard after all these years.
Would you like to analyze that swing, Dave?
Well, we'll give him a little help there.
That's it. That's the tree.
But actually, that tree cost maybe Tom Pertzer the U.S. Open that year when he decided to take